Hello there and welcome back. This is a tutorial for Adobe Illustrator and showing a quick way to trace an image that is a graphic such as a JPEG, a PNG, a bitmap, or all kinds of other pictures and quickly turn it into an illustrated vector art. Now, before we get started with that, something you really, really need to know. Many people are guilty of going to Google or Bing, searching what they want, and grabbing these little icons, thumbnails right here, and saving them. That is a tremendous mistake. Do not do that. Here's why. When you click on the image, it will load a larger version. This is a thumbnail. And it is very important when you use Illustrator to trace an object that you have the highest quality, highest resolution version possible. In this example, this is the thumbnail, the small version dragged from right here. This is the larger version opened on the side. Notice a difference in quality. If I resize this, now the difference is pretty extreme. That's because the one on the left is a thumbnail with very low resolution. Resolution means the number of pixels horizontal and vertical that define that picture. You need a high resolution so that Illustrator can more easily identify these lines and edges and trace them. So how do we do that? Okay, in Illustrator, open a new document and add the image you want to trace. Let's start off with this picture of a black and white bat. So here is a very basic black and white bat image. Now notice that when I first place it, it gives a blue boundary box around it and an X through it. That is because this is a JPEG. It is not a picture that Illustrator can edit. It is pixel based. We need to vectorize it. To do that, here's the process. It's very simple. Select your object with the Select tool. Go to the Object menu and choose Live Trace, Make, and Expand. Now you will notice upon tracing it that your picture will be suddenly full of paths and anchor points defining the areas of high contrast. Something else you may notice that is when you click on it, you will see a bounding box outlining the entire shape of the picture you had, whether it was a JPEG, a PNG, or whatever. And it's all grouped together when you move it. Therefore, you need to ungroup it. Right click and choose ungroup, or go to the object menu and choose ungroup. Depending on the complexity of your picture and the version of Illustrator, you may need to ungroup it a few times. Now, right now, if you have really good eyes, you may observe that there is a white area around it, or a semi-transparent white area. That is something you need to remove before laser cutting or doing a variety of other design manufacturing processes. So in this case, we do not want this bounding box with this white material, so delete it. I also do not want all of this stuff. Thank you, VectorStock. Delete that as well. That should leave us just the vectorized outline of our bat that we can now resize, reshape, distort, edit, or whatever we want. Okay, let's see the same process now with a slightly more complicated picture. Let's start off with our thumbnail, the low resolution image, and let's get the higher resolution image next to it. I'm not going to resize either of these. These are the actual sizes based on the files we downloaded. So the first one, object, live trace, make, expand. The second one, object, live trace, make, and expand. Now you will notice immediately that all the color went away, leaving nothing but a black and white object. That is correct. There are ways to preserve some of the color detail, but that is not going to be covered in this lesson. Once again, we can see that if we resize this, the quality of these two objects are quite different. Let's make these match. So here is the object on the left, the bat on the left, and the bat on the right. And look at the ears, for example. There is a huge difference in the quality of output, and that was due to the limited number of pixels. Can you read vector stock on both objects? No, you cannot. Once again, you must download the highest resolution possible for the highest quality output. Again, this image has a lot of white in it that's not needed. Let me try to explain more in depth as to why that's not needed. First, I'm going to ungroup it end, I'm going to want to delete all these white pieces. Why? All right, imagine that you are going to laser cut this. That means you're going to put this, a piece of wood or acrylic, in a laser cutter, and the machine is going to cut along all of these pathways that define our object. What that means is it's going to cut the lines that define the black wings, but then it's also going to define the lines that made this box. So you have a path here for the wings, you have a set of paths here for the wings. In other words, it's going to cut those areas twice. That is a waste of time and power for the machine. If your goal is not to cut, but to only etch or burn the object into a material, then it's going to do the process twice, because laser cutters and other devices don't care about the color here, they only care about the paths. So we do not want to duplicate paths. So remove all of those. Now you notice also there are white pieces inside here for the body, the wings, the head. How do you get rid of all of these? A great and simple trick. Select one of them. Go to the Select menu, choose Same Fill Color. In other words, select every object on the page that has the same fill color. In this case, white. We don't want any of those. Look at all these white pieces. And delete them. Now when I click inside the wings, I am not clicking on anything, just the paper in the background or the artboard. We can also get rid of this. Thank you again, Vectorstock. Now, once again, this is all ungrouped because we just ungrouped it, which means if you want to keep it together, you need to select it again, right click, or go Object Menu, Group. And there is our cartoon bat, now vectorized, ready for action. Of course, this process is not perfect. Notice all of these extra little whatevers here. This is something you would want to fix by going in here very carefully with the pen tool and subtracting and removing all of the unnecessary anchors and then cleaning these up. And this would take just a little bit of time, but it's something you can certainly do. Use the direct select to adjust those handles and smooth everything out. Now then, let's see our final example. This one comes from a real photograph of an actual bat, and we will do the same process. Thumbnail on the left, actual photo on the right. Now watch how poorly this is going to happen. Object, live trace, make expand. The other one, object, live trace, make expand. Look at what happened. We've lost so much quality and clarity. It's difficult to even understand that that is a bat. Why did that happen? That happened because these objects have very poor contrast. Illustrator is not so good at identifying boundary edges of low contrast. So these wings are mostly black, the background is black, and Illustrator was unable to define those as separate objects. Therefore, when live tracing, it is superior and almost always a better outcome if you start by selecting silhouettes. Let's go back to the internet. By selecting cartoons, clip art, or silhouettes. However, if you have to use an actual photograph, before you live trace it, you need to edit this for live tracing. How can you do that? Use a program like Photoshop and remove the background. Delete the black background or whatever is preventing the contrast. Replace it with something bright, white, yellow, blue in this case, bright blue, pink. That will allow Illustrator to see the edges of the wings and the body, and then you could live trace it. The same would be true for any photograph with poor contrast. Okay, I hope you are now able to live trace images and get even more out of Illustrator. Thanks for watching.